So we're here with Christiane, Ayana, and Sheldon, who will be meeting with all the suppliers who are coming together to make this dream wedding a reality. But hey, we're going to start at the best place, the food.
Everyone will admit that one of the main attractions of a wedding is, of course, the food. The menu of any wedding is always well thought out and planned, from the appetizer to the dessert.
We have prepared for you all as a sample, just to give you an idea as to what to expect on the day. We have from the appetizers right down to the desserts. So we've started with we have samosas and chutneys, we have stuffed eggs. These items will be used to entertain your guests at your cocktail hour at poolside while we serve them wine and champagne. That's when you guys will be taking photos. They'll have some stuff to munch on. Then we will start, when you come upstairs after photos, we'll start with your salads and then move on to your main entrees, which would then go into your meats. You have a fish dish, we have a chicken dish, vegetable, and your two starches. And then you'll end up with your ultimate dessert items for you and your guests.
This aroma getting me real hungry right now.
Well, it's here for you all to take a sample and dig in, so you can feel free. We will take out
sample
for you guys.
I'm gonna take the whole table home right now.
Feel free to do that, because all is for you right
These
now.
These are samosas, is
it? Samosas, yes. It's a light pastry that is surrounded by, it's with flour and stuff, and you have a meat or a vegetable filling, so it will work well for both vegetarians and non-vegetarians alike.
This is good.
That's something that's very important with your menu. You need to take into consideration
that you have to cater for both.
Yes, you have people with different dietary needs, and you need to take that into consideration when you're planning your menu. It's not what you want and every single thing that you'd like to eat. And food is a way of expressing yourself as well.
Exactly.
So you find that you can be adventurous in your food. For instance, if you look at the Hawaiian chicken.
Yeah.
What Trini know about Hawaii? But at the end of the day, we know about a good baked chicken and about pairing pineapple, sweet with it.
Right.
Exactly.
So
and
fancy
Hawaii,
name.
Tropical, Trinidad, tropical. So again, you have that there.
Yeah.
And everything here
Precious.
Complements each other on the plate. You don't choose items that you want broccoli and white sauce, you want basmati rice, you want baked potatoes, everything would be white on the plate. So you need to liaise with your coordinator, liaise with your menu specialist, and they will give you their professional advice and let you know what items pair up well together, because you're looking at taste as well. Not everything goes well together. You may want to choose a Arabic dish to go with a Creole dish, and that would be like totally off. So you need to liaise with them and ensure that the menu that you choose, yes, you get what you want, but you make sure that you have items there as well. That will taste good and complement each other on the plate, because you don't want your guests looking at a plate of food and it's like, blah.
Yeah. Yeah. Or maybe asking, what is this?
What is this? Exactly. So
my family will ask, what is this? And like the idea of catering for different people.
Definitely the best. The best hands. We take the utmost care when you're at Pier 1.
The lucky couple met with interior decorator Allison Leloy of Precious Creations to start the planning for their dream wedding decor.
The colors we chose were ivory, gold, and burnt orange.
Yes.
And our floor plan here, where we have two pieces of the floor plan. This is what like bird's eye view looking down of what the place would be like, and a backdrop and a staircase.
All right.
So your staircase could look like this, and ivory and gold.
Nice. Yeah, like
you like this one?
Yeah, classy, exactly what I want.
All right, and
something
your chair
classy.
Back
stands out.
Yeah. Ivory with gold runners. So, and then our backdrop.
It'll be similar to this, right?
Similar to that.
Yeah.
Yes,
love
and ivory and burnt orange. So, if you like this.
This is nice. I mean, I like the background effect, the kind of pleated effect. That's nice. Yeah, love that.
Draped.
And the drapery. And then we have two parasols on the side with flowers.
And that will match into the color scheme as well, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
And then your cake table will go onto the side, where we will decorate it also. In the ivory gold.
I understand. So, I like, like the table. That means committing only four people, persons, sorry.
Well, we kind of did this because like for the bride and groom and the chief bridesmaid and the best man, because I don't know how much, you know, like the wedding party.
Yeah. Well, bridal.
The party is large.
I don't think that they will all be able to fit on the head table. Mm. So I guess it would just be the four of us.
Yeah. Just the four of you, and then one of the first tables here would be reserved for the.
Right. Oh, okay, yeah, that sounds
and
good.
There's like these here would be like for your parents on each side, family of it.
And I really love fountains. I like something with a little water, so I guess you'll...
Yeah, at the bottom of the staircase, in between the two pillars, we put in a fountain.
Okay, right here.
Yeah.
So as people enter...
All
right.
They will see this, the fountain, and you'll also have...
So this is how it will look, right?
Yes, this is how it will look.
Okay.
Like this. Mm-hmm. And you'll have the table here with the sign-in book.
Okay.
For your guests.
Interesting.
What about the tables and stuff like that? How are we going to do the tables for the guests?
For the guests?
Yeah.
Well, they're 10-seater tables.
Oh.
All right. So it would be in ivory with a gold runner across. Ivory chair backs. The centerpiece, if you like it.
I love it.
Yeah.
Actually, I was going to tell you that.
I love it.
Yeah. You like it?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, this
and
will be fun.
I love that effect.
This is the centerpiece.
Really nice.
And then we put it on a runner. The gold runner, and we probably have some candles on the side.
So each table will have a centerpiece like this, right?
Yes. Okay. Yes. Each table will have a centerpiece like this.
I love how you incorporated burnt orange into the ivory and gold and that greenery and stuff.
I was thinking that burnt orange was kind of was a bright color, you know, like from wearing orange.
No. It's like a copper. Copper, very burnty. So it looks very nice with
the
gold
and
the ivory.
Amazing.
Beautiful, I love it.
So I'm sure when you come that day, it will look just like how you see these pictures.
Yeah.
These are what really.
And what about the arrangement on the head table?
On the head table. Well, these are all the, like the ferns have like roses and white. Similar to that. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. And we try to keep it more green and white for the head table.
All right. And plants, will the plants be lit like little lights in between?
You'll have like six ficus trees lit around the room. Like on behind the cake table in the corner, you'll have a ficus tree on each side by the DJ. Then where the step down is, you'll have another two.
Ficus is this?
The ficus trees look like a tall one to this.
Okay.
And they're all lit
with
white lights.
Yeah, like just the plants well lit, and I love that effect, especially at night or any kind of evening.
Yeah,
I love that.
Okay.
This looks lovely.
Like that, that drapery device.
Yeah, the background effect, I mean.
I absolutely love it.
No, I agree because, I mean, from looking at the pictures here, I mean, I like the effect that the background gives.
Drapery and everything, right? Yeah.
And the light coming through and then with the pink, I mean, well, I guess it'll be
copper.
Copper. Yeah. I mean, I could just see it right now, you know, looking, it really look good.
Yeah. I think this is it, you know. I really think
this is
what we'll be seeing on the 5th of November.
Right behind the 100. I support it 100%.
I love it.
All right.
Ayan and Sheldon meet with Christine of Hallmark and went through some of the options that were available to match the decor, theme, and their individual style.
Have you looked at any designs anywhere in the internet?
No.
No?
We looked online.
Yeah, we did. I mean, she likes to see flowers, I believe, on a card. You know, she likes the
ideas.
Yeah.
Well, the wedding basically is of the bride. Your opinion is important as well, but let's take it from there.
Yeah, it's mostly bright. And by the way, our color theme is burnt orange, gold, and ivory.
Good.
So we're looking at something around it.
If you don't find an invitation here in those particular color schemes, we can actually create that scheme for you. At Hallmark, we are able to manipulate any of the designs. So you can't get any color that you're looking for.
Oh, okay.
That's good.
All right, that's great, yeah.
Because, I mean, to get burnt orange is a difficult task, I realize.
Yeah.
I mean, gosh.
And we weren't too sure what color font we want as well, whether it be gold or burnt orange. And seeing that you're the professional, I guess you would tell us exactly well whether gold would look better, especially for a formal location like this.
If you have an exact shade of orange, burnt orange,
All you have to do is provide maybe a swatch of the bridesmaids' dresses.
Okay.
If that's the color the dresses are going in, mm-hmm. or a swatch of any of the color scheme that you're going to be using.
All right.
I will continue going. This is a bit casual for you.
Yeah.
How about something like this?
I love this. Can I have this?
Yeah, it's cool. I mean,
we can work with this. You're not necessary to use this image. Mm-hmm. You can actually put maybe a photograph of yourself. Mm-hmm. Like I said, you know, we are able to change the design to suit you guys.
Yeah. And actually, we were thinking of that. Yeah.
How does this color suit you? Do you like it?
Yeah, I'm wondering now if I should really go with ivory and gold, mm-hmm. you know, and just add touches of burnt orange, you know, and so.
Maybe a good idea, I guess.
I don't know.
I find gold, I mean, it really sets
up. It stands out.
Yeah.
Let's identify this as maybe your first choice.
Yeah, and a picture here of us, you know, because we are looking at. That would be really nice.
A good substitute, I mean, picture of us.
So will it be a colored picture or will it be black and white? What do you recommend?
I would recommend black and white.
Black and white
or
picture.
Or maybe sepia, you know, where it's a shade, you have different shades of maybe browns.
Okay.
To complement the design.
Alright.
Okay, but would it show up like this or would it be like, like this, you know how a watermark looks, is that like a faint, like grayish image?
Faded.
Yeah.
It would be more like a watermark.
Oh, okay. That one not too bad. That'll look,
that'll look
nice. That'll
look nice.
Like the other, see my face on our card.
Yeah, me too.
Well, what are these more or less? I mean, like,
these just give you the idea of, you know, the edges, the borders.
Okay.
But I think we're looking for more with the gold highlights.
This is pretty, the ribbons.
That's true, you might want ribbons or flowers in yours.
This is Valentine's Day-ish kind of stuff.
Not necessarily. No? Some brides, they go with roses. Mm-hmm. The entire theme is roses. Mm-hmm. Roses in the reception, roses in the church.
Right.
So this is, it can be of a Valentine nature. But it can actually work as your wedding invitation.
I like the idea of how the card is actually designed.
Yeah,
like,
how it interlocks here.
Yeah. You know.
Wow.
So.
That's nice.
That's nice. I mean, I find that's cool.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Moving on.
That might be a second option. I don't
know. Ooh. This is more like your contemporary design. This the square design.
Mm-hmm. This is different, Sheldon, isn't it?
Yeah, that is different.
I love this.
And you're getting your goal here as well.
Mm-hmm.
We'll be right back with more of The Dream Wedding.